In the previous video, we have learned how to enable TLS to secure the gRPC connection in GoLang. Today we will learn to do the same thing in Java. If you haven't watched my video about SSL and TLS, I highly recommend you to watch it first to have a deep understanding about TLS before continue. To recall, there are three types of gRPC connections. The first one is insecure connection, where all the data transferred between client and server is not encrypted. We should not use it in production. The second type is connection with server-side TLS. In this case, all the data is encrypted, but only the server needs to provide its TLS certificate to the client. We use this type of connection if the server doesn't care which client is calling its API. The third and strongest type is mutual TLS connection, where both client and server must provide their TLS certificate to each other. We use it when the server also needs to verify who's calling its services. Let's start with the server-side TLS. First, I will copy the TLS certificate generation script from PCBook GoLang to PCBook Java project. You can watch my video about how to create and sign TLS certificate to understand how this script works. Basically, this script will generate a private key and a sell-side certificate of the CA. Then it creates a private key and a CSR for the server, and uses the CA's private key to sign that CSR to create server certificate. Similarly, it will create a private key and CSR for the client, and use the same CA's private key to sign that CSR to create client certificate. For this tutorial, we use the same CA to sign both client and server certificate. But in reality, there can be multiple clients whose certificates are signed by different CAs. When we run this gen.sh script in the terminal, it will generate all private keys and certificates for the CA, the server, and the client. This is a CA certificate, the CA's private key, the client's certificate, the client's private key, the server's certificate, and the server's private key. Now on the server, I will add a new static function to load TLS credentials and return an SSL context object. First, we create two objects to load the server certificate and private key. Then we call SSL context builder.forServer function and pass in those two files. For server-side TLS, we can set client auth to none, which means we don't need client to send its certificate. After that, we call gRPC SSL context.configure, pass in the SSL context builder object, then call .build to build the SSL context and return it to the caller. Next, I will add a new constructor for the laptop server, which will take one more additional input, the SSL context. This constructor will create a laptop server object with TLS. To do that, here, instead of using gRPC.serverBuilder, we should use native server builder. And we call .SSL context function of that builder to pass in the SSL context. Now, in the main function, all we need to do is load the TLS credentials to build a SSL context, then pass that context into the new laptop server constructor. And we are done with the server. Let's run it. The server is started. Now, if we try to connect the current client to this new server, the request will fail because we haven't enabled TLS on the client side yet. So let's do that. Similar to the server, I will define a function to load TLS credentials from PAM files. But this time, we only need to load the certificate of the CA who signed server certificate. The reason is the client need to use CA certificate to verify the certificate it receives from the server. Here we just call gRPC SSL context.fork client, then call .trustManager and pass in the CI certificate file, and finally call .build to build the SSL context and return it. After that, we add a new constructor to create a laptop client with TLS enabled. This constructor will take a SSL context as input. And inside, we use native channel builder instead of managed channel builder. And we replace this use plaintext call with the SSL context. Alright, now in the main function, we just load the TLS credentials to make a SSL context and pass it into the new laptop client constructor. And the client is done. Let's try it. This time the requests are successfully sent to the server. So the server side TLS is working as expected. For mutual TLS, it is required that the client also shares its certificate with the server. So on the server side, we change this client auth to require. And we need to load the certificate of the CA who signed client certificate in order to verify it. In our case, it's the same CA who signed the server certificate. Just like what we did on the client side, here we just add one more command, .trustManager, and pass in the CA certificate. And we are done with the server. Now if we restart the server, and try to connect the client to it, the request will fail because we haven't updated the client to send its certificate to the server. So let's do that. I will just copy and paste this block of code from the server and change the variable names and file names from server to client. Then in this command, we just add .keyManager and pass in the client certificate and private key. And that's it. Let's run the client. All requests are successful now. So we have successfully enabled mutual TLS for our gRPC connection. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.